It is the incident before 8 to 10 years. It was 3 days to go to Diwali, and my electric meter's wire, which was already loosened, accidentally got disconnected. So it was a governmented meter, so I could not do anything. Before we had that old meter, and the old meter downside lid was opened. So I used to entangle the wire into the nails, and the electricity would come. Otherwise, I would call a private mechanic, and he would connect the wire on the basic charge of 20 to 50 rupees. But at this time, I was unable to do anything because of the new meter installed. So I rushed to the powerhouse. And I asked many officers. So I was told to pay 400 rupees for all kind of formalities. But it was still more for me, much more for me, because I was not able to afford that much money. So I requested to others, and finally I got one very gentle clerk. He asked me 150 rupees for all kind of formalities. I just gave him. The next day, two persons came to my home, I can say from the powerhouse, and they broke the seal and they connected the wire. And at the time of when they were leaving, they asked me for money. So I took out 50 rupees note from my pocket and handed over to them. At this, they got, as they saw the 50 rupees note, they got angry on me. And again, they asked me for 200 rupees. So I just gave them 200 rupees note on the name of TN Coffee. And but actually, they did not do the complete work. They did not do the complete work because they broke the seal, but they did not install the new seal. So when I asked about them that why you did not do the complete work, you broke the seal, but you did not install the new seal of the meter. So on that they said that the new seal would be installed by the other men from to the next day, means tomorrow. I agreed anyhow, and the next day two more persons came to my home. They installed the new seal, and they also asked for money on the name of TN Coffee. When I asked him how much, they just told me 200 rupees. So I don't know where these electricians would go, where these electricians go to take tea, which cost 200 rupees for tea and coffee. I still take tea, minimum 5 rupees or maximum 10 rupees on any tea shop. So government make the rules for the welfare of the society and the people. But I don't know where the rule goes, where the rules go and out of the direction, otherwise wrong direction, otherwise we do not follow the rules, otherwise the officers do not follow the rules. So you have to decide what is correct and what is wrong. And this is the proof. What kind of a proof do we need more than that? That the work which I could do within a minute. Otherwise, after spending 50 to 100 rupees for the same work, I had to pay 550 rupees, and on the top of that, I also just lost 2 days remuneration, and more than that, I just spent 2 nights in the dark. So now it was my experience that I wanted to share with you guys in English. You can also share any moment, any incident in English by using very simple sentences. You do not hesitate, do not judge yourself that you are speaking right or wrong. Try to speak whether it is wrong or right, and find out the teacher near to you, and you can just ask them the feedback that you spoke by any sources, by video, by audio source, anywhere. Just send them and ask them for their feedback. If you do not find out the teacher nearby you, you can just WhatsApp me your audios and videos, and I will definitely tell you the feedback on your videos and audios, and that where you are committing the mistakes. By this way, you can improve yourself, because speaking begets speaking. then grammar would not help you in the speaking. Grammar is really very necessary for all kind of means language. In any language you need grammar, but for speaking you need only the minor grammar, which only consists the sequence of the words. And if you get that, definitely you will be able to speak any kind of a language. Thank you and have a nice day. So start here, speak anywhere.